I'm a member of a bunch of different social media discussion forums for high intensity training. And when I say high intensity training, I mean very hard, but brief and infrequent strength training, not sprint interval training or CrossFit or boot camps or any of the other silliness that a lot of people erroneously call high intensity training. Those things are not high intensity training. That's not what I'm talking about. Often, people will post videos in these forums of themselves performing some exercise or sometimes a workout, asking for feedback on their form. And the form almost always sucks. It is terrible. But most people don't know any better. They haven't seen exercises performed properly. There's very few examples of correct form out there. And you see this in a lot of the feedback in the comments too. 9 out of 10 people see this video with horrible form and tell them how great it is. They just don't know any better. There are some people, there are some of you who get it and who do try to provide constructive feedback, but the vast majority of people just don't have a clue. So if your form sucks, and almost all of you watching this probably have bad form. In fact, somebody might have shown you this video because your form sucks. I anticipate people are going to be posting the link in a lot of the kind of threads in the forums that have the videos like the ones I'm talking about. I'm going to talk about just a couple things that you can do to improve it. Obviously, I can't go over every single thing that people get wrong because there's a lot. In general, and even more so for specific exercises. But here are some of the biggest things that you can do to help. The first is to learn the difference between the real and the assumed objective of exercise. A lot of people exercise wrong and they use poor form because they're trying to do the wrong thing. To stimulate the body to produce an improvement in the function of some tissue, some system, we have to challenge its ability to perform that function. We have to impose a stress on it. The function of your muscles is to produce force, to stimulate your body to produce an improvement in that function, an increase in strength and muscular size. We challenge that by working the muscles against meaningful resistance, a level of resistance that is challenging enough to result in very deep fatigue in a relatively short amount of time. Around a minute, but probably not more than two. Most people should be using an amount of resistance, a weight that allows them to achieve momentary muscle failure within about 60 to 90 seconds, maybe a little higher, a little lower for some people, but that's a good starting point. Assuming good form. Your goal is not to make the weight go up and down, though. Making weight go up and down is a means to an end. The goal is to use the resistance provided by the weight to efficiently load and fatigue to inroad the strength levels of the targeted muscles. As you approach momentary muscle failure, as the exercise becomes more difficult, you need to focus on that inroading process, on attempting to, again, continue to efficiently load and deeply fatigue the targeted muscles, not making the weight go up and down. A lot of people start sacrificing form. Actually, most people's form, again, sucks from the very start, but even people with good form, if they do not have the correct objective in mind, if they're focusing on the wrong thing, focusing on what they're doing to the weight with their muscles instead of what they're doing to their muscles with the weight will tend to alter their form as the exercise becomes more difficult, as the muscles are fatigued, because they're just trying to move the weight. How well you perform every repetition of an exercise is far more important than how many you do. You don't compromise your form. You don't cheat. You don't do any of these things for the sake of keeping the weight moving. You want to continue to contract the target muscles intensely, but you don't alter your form in a way to make the exercise easier to keep the weight moving. That's the opposite of what we want. We want to get the muscle to that point of momentary muscle failure within our target time under load. So that's the first part, is the correct mindset. Stop thinking about doing something to the weight. Stop thinking about trying to just make weight go up and down. This is not competitive lifting. Think about using the weight to try to deeply fatigue the targeted muscles. Just getting that right helps to solve a lot of the other problems. A lot of form problems, not all, but a lot of form problems are the result of people trying to do the wrong thing. Trying to make the weight go up and down instead of using the weight to efficiently load and fatigue the targeted muscles. So the next thing most people get wrong is moving way too fast. Again, it's not about making weight go up and down. In fact, the number of times that a weight goes up and down is not as important as the tension in the muscles and the duration. And this is not just my opinion. There are a bunch of reasons for this that I'm not going to get into here, having to do with things like the force velocity curve, safety. But there have been some studies looking at this. When you match the time under load so that subjects are achieving momentary muscle failure within a similar duration, there's no advantage to moving faster. Your results are going to be pretty much the same. It's going to be easier on your joints and spine, though, if you are going slower. You should not be yanking and jerking and heaving and throwing, bouncing the weight. I see people doing their exercises and they're just trying to throw the weight practically. You should not be moving rapidly during exercise. You want to move very slowly. At least slowly enough that you are able to do a few things. First, you want to move slowly enough that you are able to maintain strict body position throughout the entire exercise. You don't want to be moving around or twisting or anything like that. You want to maintain the correct body position throughout the exercise without any extraneous body movement. It is easier to do this when you're moving slowly. It is easier to strictly control your path and range of motion when you are moving slowly, allowing you to make sure you're moving in a way that you are keeping the tension on the targeted muscles, not offloading it onto other muscle groups. You should move at least slowly enough that you are able to reverse direction smoothly, perform correct turnaround technique between the positive and negative phases. The change of direction should be gradual, not rapid or jerky. You shouldn't be bouncing or heaving out of the start. In fact, when you begin an exercise, I see a lot of people do this wrong. For example, you get the handles on a shoulder press or a chest press, or you put your feet on the pedal of a leg press machine or the footboard and you just go. Don't do that. The start should be very controlled and gradual. You want to barely apply any effort initially, and then very slowly, gradually apply a little bit more and a little more force until the weight just barely begins to move. And once it does, then you just apply enough force to keep it moving at a relatively slow and controlled pace. You don't just go, but you gradually apply force, increasing until the weight just barely starts moving. Very strict, slow, controlled starts in addition to reversing direction smoothly. You want to go slowly so that you are able to focus on the contraction, on the tension in the targeted muscles, so that you are able to maintain or, if necessary, adjust your body position, your path, your range of motion, to keep the tension on those muscles. In some exercises, leg press, squat, there is a point in the range of motion towards the end where the resistance starts to drop off more rapidly. You want to avoid that. You don't want to fully extend the knees in those exercises. In fact, you want to avoid the last 15 to 20 degrees of the range of motion. There's no benefit to it. You want to keep those targeted muscles under load. There's no meaningful loading near the end point of a squat or a leg press. So you want to perform the upper turnaround reverse direction when you start to feel that tension dropping off more rapidly. If you are moving too quickly, it is going to be difficult for you to feel that and to be able to perform that turnaround at the right time. Soon enough that you're not underloading the target muscles, but not so that you're not getting some range of motion. Although range of motion, the benefit of which is grossly overestimated. That's a topic for another video. I'm not going to get into that here though. But those three things. You want to move at least slowly enough that you're able to maintain strict body positioning and path and range of motion. You want to move at least slowly enough that you are able to reverse direction smoothly at the start and end of the range of motion without any bouncing, yanking, jerking, heaving, or any kind of quick movement. You want to move at least slowly enough that you are able to focus on the contraction, on the tension in the target muscles, and be able to make adjustments when necessary to keep them under tension. As an absolute minimum cadence or maximum speed, I would recommend about 4 seconds to lift, 4 seconds to lower. If you include turnaround time and a hold or squeeze at the end point on some compound and simple movements, depending on the equipment being used, it should come out to about 10 seconds per rep. If you're doing more than 6 or 7 repetitions in a minute, you are moving too fast. In fact, I would recommend going about twice as slow as that. There's no downside to it, other than that it requires a bit more discipline and it can be a little more uncomfortable. But that would be about the minimum, about a 4-4 cadence, absolute minimum cadence or maximum speed that you should be using during exercises. And yes, the same cadence is going to result in slightly different speed for exercises with different range of motion or for individuals with different range of motion due to variation, flexibility, limb length, and all of this stuff. It's not that big of a deal. 4 seconds up and down, as again, a minimum for most exercises for most people is going to give you adequate control. And if it doesn't go slower, the next thing I see a lot of people doing wrong is not breathing correctly. They're holding their breath. This is the big thing. You should not be holding your breath. You should not be grunting, groaning, and making any kind of noises. You should be breathing freely through an open mouth throughout the exercise, not inhaling when you're lowering and exhaling when you're lifting, not taking a deep breath and then holding your breath throughout the rep. In fact, if you are using an adequately slow speed of movement, if you are moving as slowly as you should be during an exercise, that's not a lot of breaths per minute. And if you're working as hard as you should be, you're going to need a lot of breaths per minute. Don't hold your breath. Don't try to match your breathing to your movement. Again, this isn't competitive lifting. Completely different requirements. A lot of people do their exercises like they're trying to do a competitive lift, often because they're trying to show off. But again, the goal of competitive lifting, maximize the weight relative to the effort. The goal of exercise, efficient muscular loading and deep inroading within a relatively short time. But that requires maximizing the effort relative to the weight. Completely different activities, different goals. You don't breathe during exercise the way you would breathe during a competitive lift. This is also the problem with getting advice on how to exercise from powerlifters who can't make the distinction. Don't hold your breath. Don't go, don't groan, don't yell, or any of those things. Breathe freely. Also, I see people engaging in all sorts of histrionics. Behavior that is completely unnecessary for the exercise, that detracts from the safety of the exercise. And I think a lot of people do this because they think it gives the impression that they're working hard. What it is lack of discipline. Don't be doing this where you're moving your head all over the place and squirming. Again, the goal is not to just make the weights move. It is to use the weight to efficiently load and fatigue the target muscles. A lot of times when people are starting to contort their body, they're trying to gain leverage because they're focusing on moving the weight instead of keeping their muscles under tension. Stop squirming around. Keep your head and neck still. Stop making silly faces. Your face should be relaxed. You should be stoic, disciplined, not engaging in all sorts of histrionic attention-getting behavior. No yelling, no making silly faces. Making silly faces and yelling and all this drama does not mean that you're working hard. It means that you are not disciplining yourself adequately in your form when you're doing the exercises. And if you're a trainer, you should strongly discourage this in your clients. Don't let them do all this goofy stuff. Focus on the real objective: efficient muscular loading and inroading, not just making weight go up and down. Slow down. Lift and lower the weight slowly under strict control. Reverse direction smoothly without yanking, bouncing, jerking, heaving, or any other kind of sudden movement. Perform your starts gradually. Breathe freely and continuously through an open mouth. Stop making silly faces and squirming and moving your head and neck around during the exercises. These are the biggest ones. There's a lot more. If I were to go back through videos that people have posted over the past just couple of weeks, I could probably make a list of a few dozen general form mistakes and then more specific to all of the individual exercises. Again, that's not what I'm trying to do in this video. I'm just trying to get you to fix the biggest problems. But hopefully some of you listen, and hopefully if you apply this, it will help. One more thing: to be able to do some of these things, you're going to have to cut your weight. You shouldn't be doing sets that last like 15 to 20 seconds or so. Your sets should last longer. This is a big part of the problem. People, oh, I did HIIT and it didn't work. Or why am I not getting results? Because you're not deeply inroading the target muscles. Big part of stimulating strength increases. This is why some people need to do more sets, because each individual set, it sucks. If you do it correctly, then you don't need to do a bunch of them. Part of doing it correctly is using a weight that allows for adequate time under load. Most of you have shitty form because you're also, in addition to just not knowing these things, you're trying to lift a lot more weight than you should be. The goal is not to move a lot of weight. It is to efficiently load and inroad, to deeply fatigue the targeted muscles. And there have been a bunch of studies over the past, man, I think, you know, 6-7 years now that have been coming out showing that you don't need a super heavy weight to effectively stimulate muscular strength and size increases. Not a huge difference whether you're going very heavy or lower if you are working to momentary muscle failure or even pretty close to it. Although you should be going to momentary muscle failure, most people's ability to judge proximity to it sucks. You're better off just going there so you know that you've done it. You don't need to use a super heavy weight. And yes, it's going to be a big blow to a lot of people's egos. Most of you are probably going to have to cut your weight by at least half to be able to use correct form for an adequate duration. So what? Are you going to the gym because you want to get the best possible results from your workouts as safely as possible? You don't want to. A lot of the things I'm telling you here are going to save your joints, save your spine in the long run, probably help you avoid some other injuries. Are you going to the gym to show off? Are you posting these videos to show off? Or are you really trying to get the best possible results? Are you trying to exercise in a way that is as effective and safe as possible? So cut your weight in half, at least. Conservatively, based on most of the videos, a lot of the form that I've been seeing in these public groups, Most people would need to cut it back at least that much, both to be able to learn and practice using the weight correctly, and to be, again, with good form, able to achieve momentary muscle failure within a more appropriate time under load. So cut your weight. Anyways, that's all I'm going to say for right now. If people do want more specifics, because this is just tip of the iceberg, if you want more specifics, I cover all of these details in a lot of videos. Actually, I go into a lot more explanation about why, as well as covering a lot of specific details and how to correctly set up and load into and perform other exercises. So if you guys want that stuff, there's a link. It's like right down here, bay.com/hit-list. Go and join that forum. You can watch all those videos there. But just focus more on how well you do your repetitions than how many you do. Slow down. Breathe. Stop making silly faces. And cut your weight until you're able to do all those things. Then start gradually increasing it again. Normally, at the end of these videos, I would say if you've got questions, post them down below. I'll be able to address and answer them in the comments. But anticipating that this is going to be posted in a bunch of different places, and I'm not going to know where half of them are, I'm not going to say that. Instead, if you have questions about this stuff or if you want to learn more, again, go here. Go to bay.com/hitlist. Join. Once you are in the forum, then ask the questions, and I will answer them in as much detail as you require. And if necessary, I can post videos on additional exercises if you want to see how to do certain things correctly.